lose positioning, his defensive positioning when he would throw the jab. Just little things, subtle things that showed me he was controlling the pace, and it wasn't too fast for him. So I was saying, you know what, maybe he's going to be able to maintain this. But I noticed in round 5 he slowed a little. I noticed in round 6 he slowed a little. And I was wondering, did he slow down on purpose to save it for the late rounds? Because he hasn't taken a lot of shots, you know, or is he, you know, is he starting to tire? Obviously, I'm never going to know because he got knocked out cold. So, you know, we're not going to know if he was saving any energy for the late rounds. But really impressive the way he was boxing. You know, I can't say enough. It was something. It was something special. And then of course the knockout was also something special. A great one punch knockout.
What did you make of Canelo calling Triple G into the ring and making those comments that he did?
Hey man, I want to see the fight. You know, talking. You can talk to a certain point, but talking never won any fights, right? I mean, trust me, I can tell you. I talked a lot in my career. I didn't always win the fight. You know, but you know, it's great to sell the fight. It's great to do all that. But hopefully they make the fight. It'd be a good fight.
What next, Ramir Khan now?
I think he goes back to the welterweight division. You know, I don't think he lost a lot of luster in this fight. Yeah, he took a loss, but you know, he took a big risk and he boxed well in the loss. I'd love to see him against Kell Brook. Hopefully they can make that fight happen. I think the fans in England would love to see it. Like I said, I don't think Amir lost any luster here, so I think it would be a huge mega event in England. I think he's going to be the mandatory for Danny Garcia, so we'll see how that plays out. I guess Amir has some choices at the welterweight division because, as I said, if he didn't lose luster, he's going to be able to take his pick.
We know about Canelo's bad, but did you expect that?
I expected Canelo to stop him. I did expect Canelo to stop
him. In that fashion?
I expected him to break him down. I really did. I thought Amir would box well in some spots, but I expected Canelo to land shots and start breaking him down. But as the fight wore on, I started saying, how's he going to break him down? He's not sustaining anything. There's no sustained attack here. So I was starting to wonder, can he break him down? Because to break somebody down, your attack needs to be sustained. And he would just land the shot here, land the shot there. And I'm like, this is not sustained enough to break Amir down. But that's where I was wrong, because he didn't need a sustained attack. He needed one good shot on the button, and that was it.
Paulie, you were adamant that weight classes matter. Do you think size was the difference?
Absolutely. You know, the big difference was the size. You know, Amir had to walk that tightrope the entire time because he's fighting a naturally bigger guy, and you're walking that tightrope. And what happens when a guy's walking this tightrope over Niagara Falls? You're like, oh man, is he gonna fall? And it's always excitement. It's always adrenaline, no matter how he's doing it, because he's doing. And if he just slips up a little bit, oh, and then he holds on. You know, round 5, Amir slowed a little bit, so you maybe.